Hello, everyone, and welcome to Carl Hansen's open house event. My name is Gabriel, and I'll be your moderator today. And to introduce myself briefly, I'm a design journalist and copywriter based here in Copenhagen. And I'm currently sitting at Carl Hansen's offices here in central Copenhagen, beautifully sunny day today. And I'm joined by Knut Erik Hansen. He's been the CEO of Carl Hansen & Son for almost 20 years now. And how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Nice. Yeah. And today we're here to go on a factory tour to get a peek of how the company produces its amazing furniture day in and day out. And actually, when Knut Erik and I first met, it was at this huge factory, which is located in Gelsted, which is a really small village close to Odense, which is Denmark's fourth city, which is around like 1.5 hour drive from Copenhagen. And I was impressed by the talent that Knut Erik and his team managed to gather, local carpenters honing their craft and producing some of Denmark's most iconic design pieces. So yeah, to see it for yourselves, we have a video of the factory. So yeah, here you go.
Today, we are in a factory where we employ around 450 people and have 50,000 square meters of production. But I'm looking forward to showing you the entire factory and taking you for a little run around in all the departments. So welcome and please follow me. We are now in the receiving area where all the wood is coming in from the sawmills. The area here is around 7,000 square meters and we receive wood every single day. 90% of the wood we're getting in is certified wood by FSC or other certification bureaus. 10% comes from sustainable forests all over Europe. From here, the wood will be sent into the machinery area, which is next door here. And the machines are all top modern machines, all electronically operated, all done to relieve our staff from heavy burden of cutting and grinding the wood. It's all done by machines. I find that is the best in today's market, that these heavy parts are done by machines and not wearing out people standing there with doing it all by hand. We are now at the department where we educate carpenters, apprentices. We have here, we have 24 apprentices at the moment. Part of the education is of course also to refurbish furniture that comes back here to the factory after many years of use. And then we take them in here and really do them up. And I have here an example of a wishbone chair that is approximately 40 years old. It will be done completely, refurbished, sanded down, and then a new seat will be put on. And that means you basically get a new chair after 40 years of use. This is a fantastic, for environmentally a fantastic way of refurbishing furniture, and I find it is extremely nice. Other things we are doing here is we are learning how to join pieces of boards together, all done by hand. This is of course not done every day like this anymore, but it's nice to know. And a very important part for us here is that the young people learn the trade and the work right from the beginning, so they can do all the basic things. Although today there are machines that can do it as well, I still think it's very important that we learn the basic trade in the best possible way. So you see them here doing all sorts of different things. We are doing some stairs here. And these are sample boxes that we are doing for our salespeople and our dealers around in the world. They are all being handmade here and assembled and sent out in the world. We are still together with our apprentices, and what I want to show you here is how we are using the offcuts, the waste actually. That is also being used and not thrown out. And what we are doing here are some trays. We have these are table tops that have been cut out to a round table, and there will always be some squares here left. And what we do then is we use the leftovers to make a small tray which we cut out of the waste wood. The rest here is being crushed and then used for heating of the plant here and about 400 houses in the neighborhood of the factory. So nothing is wasted. Now we are in a little more quiet department where we are doing the upholstery. The upholstery today is all still done by hand. We don't see any machine that can do it, but it takes a lot of skill to do a chair as you see here. This is the Carl Klint chair, the red chair it is called. And what we are doing now is we are putting the leather on to finish the chair. It is hours of work and all done by a very skilled person. It's beautiful, absolutely fantastic work. We store all the leather for the upholstery here. They're hanging on these big racks, and most of the leather that we getting in here comes from Scandinavia. You see a very big amount of different pieces of leather and also different qualities. All the leather goes into the machine we have here, the cutting machine, and we find the small faults, like a little hole there, which is just noted by a special pen. And up here on top you have a computer with a camera on that notices all these pieces, and then you can sort out what you can actually do on this. It will optimize the use of the leather and cut the pieces as we wanted. All the offcuts are being reused for accessories which we sell in our flagship stores.
Great, we're back. I wanted to start with talking about the factory and how it's located just a few kilometers from where your grandfather started the company in a small carpentry studio a century ago, right?
And yeah, that's right.
Yeah, can you talk a bit about the importance for you to keep production there in Gothenburg?
Well, it... Oh, of course, it's important to have the history of the company located here on this island. We have been here all through the last 113 years, and will remain here as far as I can see. We have had a number of different factories in my time since 2002. This is the third factory we have, but all in Funen Island. It is also important because we have a number of carpenters and skilled personnel, as well as administrative people that have been with us for many, many years. And many have had only one job. So, I mean, that is important for, you know, that we can continue basically to employ people through a whole lifetime.
Mm. And you have an apprenticeship scheme, right? Can you tell us a bit about that and how does it help build your team?
Yes, I mean, we of course search after skilled labor all the time. We only use skilled labor and therefore it is also important for us to educate the skilled labor ourselves. Therefore, I made an apprentice academy here in at the factory a couple of years ago, and we have now, I think it was 24 apprentices that are learning the trade right from, can you say, the very simple parts and up to the complicated thing of making a piece of furniture from the beginning to the end, with all the things handmade. Of course, later on in their lives, they will be working with the machines. They will be working in a different way. But as I also mentioned in the film, I think it is important that they know the basic and that they are very skilled in what they are doing, and therefore can take a discussion about how we are doing things, how we can improve, and things like that. So we engage people in a completely different way to just standing there doing the same thing day in and day out.
Mm. Nice. And you also mentioned the refurbishing service that you have. This is something that a lot of people, I think, are paying attention to increasingly these days. Moving away from this buy and throwaway culture. Can you tell us a bit about it? And could anyone who owns a Carl Hansen piece just bring it in and get it fixed?
Yes, of course you can. We have a repair department. It is not very big, but we have it. And we are, I can say the more amusing part is when we're getting furniture in, like you saw in the film, that are 40, 50, 60 years old, just for being refurbished a little bit, sanded and gone through in all details, and then then we weave a new seat reupholster them and send them back, and they are as new and can take another 60, 100 years of wear and tear. This is for the environment, I find very, very positive, and something that we will expand in doing over the next couple of years, definitely.
Yes. I think we have a part two of the video, so if we can continue the factory
sure.
tour.
Yeah, yes. Perfect.
So now we are at the assembling line, the place where we put all the pieces of wood together to form different products, different models of chairs. We have stopped here with the chair that we call the CH20, and which is sold as the elbow chair. This chair was designed by Wegner in 1956. And was offered to all the producers that Wegner worked with, and none of them would accept the chair because it was way too difficult to make. It looks so simple, but it isn't. The backrest here is steam bent from an enormous piece of wood and then carved out, which in those days were all handwork. And this base of the chair here is made from 9 layers of veneer that has been pressed all in one go. That was impossible in 1956. Anyhow, I got the chair from Marianne Wegner in 2003, and we made the chair, and I'm very proud of that. Today it's selling very well. It is used all over the world for both private use and also for restaurants and coffee shops and things like that. The sanding is done by each carpenter. They go out and they sand each piece of wood, which they are going to assemble later on. In that way, they know that the wood is perfect. There is no defects, and they are responsible for the products until it is assembled. They make sure that the colors of the wood match, and that there is no faults or anything in the chair. All the paint we use is water-based, so that the water that is left for the sewage is all leaving the factory here clean as it should be. The chairs get three layers of paint, and the white ones you see in the background here, that's the first layer of paint they get. And then after that, there are two more layers. The first layer is painted by a robot, and thereafter it's all hand painted. And now we come to the final part of the assembling of the chairs, the weaving. The weaving is, of course, all by hand. And what we are looking at here is the CH26. We use approximately 170 meters of paper yarn for that chair. And it takes about 1 hour and 15, 20 minutes to do the weaving. The paper yarn is made, of course, of paper. It's a Swedish invention, used during the Second World War, also for the combiners, for the harvesters. It is not fast when you tie a knot. It doesn't slip, and it's immensely strong. A chair like this here, the weaving on a chair like this here will last for 30, 40 years. So it is extremely durable and a very high quality and a beautiful handwork. We have now reached the final part of the whole operation here at the factory, and that's the dispatch area. All the furniture has been packed and they are stacked here in racks, all up under the roof, which gives us a high efficient handling of all the pieces. So we can pick and nearly every product that we are producing in this place here. The furniture is dispatched to approximately 60 different countries all over the world. Of course, the Scandinavian market is big for us, but we are getting also very nice response from other areas like United States and Asia. Japan is a very big market for us. So all in all, a company which has developed very nicely and that we are very proud of.
Nice. Great. So, yeah, it's 2020 has been a pretty strong year for you. I remember when we met last November, you told me that you've never been busier. Can you tell me approximately how many items you produce in the factory every year?
Well, we produce around 130 different products, and I wouldn't know exactly how many, but we are probably talking about a couple of hundred thousand of units going out of the factory every year.
Mm-hmm. Nice. And so, do you have any plans to expand in the next couple of months? I know you have recently, but how's demand?
We are constantly expanding, and we are building onto the factory. So the picture you just saw, it's already obsolete, but that is necessary. We have to follow the trend. We have to follow the development of the company. And this is a pleasant challenge, I would say, but also a very hard one, because we have to have the right people, we have to have the right machines, we have to, everything must be, can you say, weighed up and planned so that we have a flow through the factory, even when we expand. And that is a great challenge for many of our very good people.
Yeah. And how many countries do you currently export to?
Around 60 different countries. And as I mentioned, we have, of course, some big ones like Japan, USA, UK, Germany, and the Scandinavian countries where we are doing well, but also Southern Europe and Korea, and yeah, the whole of the Far East.
Nice. All right, so we received a couple of questions from viewers, so I'm going to start with those, if it's okay with you.
Yes, please.
Holger from Norway is asking how many craftsmen work in the factory at the moment.
We are between 400 and 450 people working in the factory right now. Of course, they are among these people are also our salespeople. We have no agents working for us. We have our own people based all over the world to sell our furniture exclusively. So we make sure that the customers have the right story, the right explanation of what they are buying from us. And we can also take the time it takes to make sure that we can assist our customers in selling the furniture and promoting. So this is a good service which we offer and which I think is appreciated all over.
Nice. Here I have a bit of more of a technical question from Leon. He's asking what percentage of American hardwood you use and what species?
We use basically only one, and that is the walnut. The walnut comes from the United States. We have the walnut trees we have in Denmark or in Europe. They are too small. And never grow to the size they do in the United States. So we import the wood from USA. We also used to import quite a lot of wood of cherry trees, but that is a fashion wood. So it's gone out again. So we don't have much of cherry trees left.
I see.
So and, that is only two. Yeah.
Okay. We got a question from Hans from the Netherlands, a bit about yourself, actually. He's asking if you're a trained carpenter yourself.
No, I'm not. I'm the first, owner of Carl Hansen, the first family member that is not a carpenter. But I have spent the first 18 years of my life running around in the factory when I was a small boy, and seeing things being done, and listening to the carpenters when they discuss the way of doing new products and things like that. So it's not something completely new for me, but I am not an educated carpenter. I am actually educated in shipping, and I was number two. My big brother took over in 1987, and I took over from him in 2002. So I'm educated actually in something completely different.
Right, nice. All right, I got one more question from Nicholas in Sweden. He is saying that sustainability seems to be playing quite a big role at Carl Hansen at the moment. And he's asking if you have a dedicated CSR team to kind of optimize the operations.
We do. It is a very important part for us, and we take any opportunity to kind of improve on what we are doing. So therefore, for instance, FSC marking of FSC certification of all the wood is very important for us. But also the packaging material and all other material we are using must be certified. There is 90% of the wood we use today is FSC marked or certified, The last 10% comes from sustainable forests, primarily in Denmark, that are not certified, but they are certainly sustainable. And this is governed by law in Denmark anyway. So, I would imagine within the next couple of years, everything we use will be FSC marked.
Hmm. Nice. And we received a question going back to the apprenticeship, actually. Do the apprentices stay at the company once their apprenticeship ends, or what happens?
We live in a free country, so everybody can do what they like when they finished their apprenticeship with Carl Hansen. But there is a very high percentage of the young people that have finished their apprenticeship that they continue with Carl Hansen and so on. Some of them choose to study further, becoming architects and designers and things like that. But the great majority stays with the company afterwards. And we make sure we have a position for them if they like. And that is something we discuss with the people, with the young people before they qualify, so that they know well in advance that they actually have a job secured before they finish.
I see. And do you run apprenticeships also for upholstery, or is it just for the country?
We can do that. I don't think we have any apprentices at the moment, but we have qualified people to educate apprentices. But I don't think we have any at the moment, unfortunately. We would like to get some.
Nice. All right. I think we're done with the questions because, I think we're running out of time now. Thanks for everybody who watched. We have more of these sessions coming up later today. I'll be joining you for one as well. And thanks everybody for joining, and thanks to Knud Erik. It's been great talking to you as always.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, all the best. Thank you.